Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to the Liebherr 2019 ITTF World Championships, coming to you live from Budapest, Hungary. I'm your commentator, Adam Bobro, and we are getting in to the most anticipated match since the world number one had been knocked out by this man right here. Da Pang took out Fang Zhendong Xiaopang, and Liang Jingquan, world number nine, runs into the court for what could be either his last match of the tournament, falling at the hands of the dictator, or it could be the greatest, most shocking, or I'd say the greatest win of his career on the big stage. But now the man who has redefined the game, the most agile, the most complete, the most adaptable player, world rank number 11 currently, it is the dragon, the captain, the dictator, Ma Long. Ma Long is many's favorite to win this tournament. But one man standing in his way right now could be a real test. Joining me in the commentary booth, a very experienced coach for a very illustrious, I'd say, career for the Englishmen. It's Don Parker. How you doing, Don?
I'm doing very well, thanks, Adam. Looking forward to this match. You know, 50 years ago today, one of the first finals that I can remember, Eberhard Scholler, the German defensive player, lost to Shigeo Ito in the final in Munich. And over the 50 years since then, there are two players that stand out in my mind that I've had the privilege to watch, challenging each other in my mind to be the greatest. Jan-Ove Waldner from Sweden, incredible player, and the gentleman we're just about to see in action. You refer to him as the dictator, Ma Long. I think if Ma Long can win it here, he probably has to become the best that I've ever seen. An incredible performance. We thought August last year, maybe that's the end. His colleagues, the fitness people in China, were worried about his career, that it could even be over. And then he's come here, Adam. I don't know if you agree, but he's playing as well as I've seen him ever play.
Yeah, it's tough to imagine that he's still missing any percentage of the recovery. It seems like he's come all the way back. He was tested in the first platinum event of the year, winning the Qatar Open. And yeah, it was pretty serious. Talking even to his teammates, they said, wow, Ma Long's really in bad shape right now. And it wasn't just one thing. It wasn't just the knee, the neck. I mean, I think lower back, they said. They were pointing to all sorts of the body. And yeah, looking strong in Qatar. Yesterday was just as solid as can be. Didn't drop a game to the Dark Knight, Lin Gaoyuan. I mean, he's on the half of the draw that had four Chinese players. He was one of the four, and he's having to battle two of the other three. Liang Jingquan, as mentioned, beat Fang Zhendong for a second time in recent history. Now, a lot of people will think, yeah, Liang Jingquan's got the power, sure, but experience, can he change it up really to challenge Ma Long? Well, the one time they played before on the World Tour, their only encounter was not so long ago. It was the 2018 China Open before Ma Long took his break for his injuries. And that was a 4-3 victory for Ma Long. So very tight. And as much as people will favor Ma Long, this really could go either way.
I think, Adam, what's interesting from a psychological point of view is Liang Jingquan is playing against a teammate. And that's tough, and you've got to be mentally tough to put that aside and focus on your own game. But he's also possibly, and you may know better than I do, he's possibly playing his hero. He's certainly playing a player that has immense respect from him, that's for sure, possibly even his hero. And again, he's got to be mentally tough there, put that out of his mind, and just focus on putting in the best performance he possibly can.
Yeah, when I think about pressure and the pressures that Liang Jingquan has, by the way, I remember when Panos, the defentist from Greece, said, oh, lucky me, I get to play Liang Jingquan in the next round. Koki Niwa gave him quite a scare. You and I had that match, and it was incredible to watch. One to go back and watch. But one thing that I will say, real quickly while we've got Ma Long on screen, defending world champion back-to-back 2015-2017 and going for a hat trick here, a turkey, if you will, the Olympic champion of 2016. And if he can double that, and get Tokyo 2020, there will be no argument. Kunik Jha, Vlady Samsonov, and Ugo Calderano, the only players to take a game off of Ma Long. That's really something. Here is Lim Ilien from Malaysia, our umpire for the match. I would like to talk about the pressure. We're going to introduce our Hungarian umpire, Attila Petovari. Now, in terms of pressure, that's such a big factor, I'd say. Liang Jingquan now doesn't have to worry about holding the weight of China on his shoulders. So that pressure has been removed. He will be forgiven by others for losing to Ma Long. The association, his coaches, will not hold him responsible at the same level as if he were to get beaten by a foreigner. And because they're teammates and they have a history together, Liang Jingquan, I think in internal tournaments, has actually beaten Ma Long three times. Not so many people can say that. That being said, Ma Long has beaten Liang Jingquan 12 of their 15 encounters internally. So definitely the favorite under pressure. We've seen Ma Long rise to the occasion and looks to be as back as can be.
But I watched the game when Liang played Fan Shendong, and psychologically he was as tough as they come in that game. He got himself psyched up, he was firing, he was punching the air. The fact he was playing one of his teammates, the fact he was playing the number one player in the world, he rose to the occasion. So it really is going to be fascinating just to see how this pans out from that all-important psychological point of view.
And just a reminder, what's on the line here in terms of stakes, the winner here will be battling for the gold medal against a non-Chinese player. So it is all open after this big fight here. And Liang Jingquan, I mean, what an opportunity to make it this far and to stop potentially Ma Long from three in a row. Not sure what the holdup is here. Flash in the crowd, music, just the music.
I think we want the barriers sorting out as well. Ah, the barriers are fine now.
What was happening with the barriers?
They were lit up brightly with a sponsor across and...
Ah, pictures of a bunch of balls all over them. All right, here we go. Liang Jingquan to start the best of seven.
One, love.
The first point right out of the gates here. This semifinal match, only one will survive and will then carry the weight of the entire nation of China. One. Clever idea. Ball goes down.
But it's interesting, isn't it, there? Ma Long, the word block isn't in his vocabulary. He's hitting those backhands hard. Liang tried to get round, ended up playing the forehand from a cramped position because the ball is just coming a little bit quicker all the time.
I always like it to see the receiver hit the ball down into their own side of the table after a let serve. Seems cool amidst all the pressure. A rip against the chop block. Liang Jingquan moves in quickly, will not submit, will not go passive against this. This one doesn't sit up very high, but just high enough for a very whippy backhand. Oh, turned the corner and had all his weight on his left leg for a moment. Couldn't come back to retrieve the wide forehand. Took the risk.
That was very quick reactions there. Just a little bit of side spin, the ball curling even further away.
Now, in terms of taking advantage of chances or opportunities, rather, Liang Jingquan, this is a very unique opportunity for him. For Ma Long, it's not so unique. He's been here before. He might not have the same level of hunger to really make sure this time counts.
One.
And obviously, they both want it incredibly bad for many reasons. So the Ma Long fan club is going to be gigantic in comparison. Again, years and years to develop his career, to be recognized internationally as superhuman, essentially. Ooh, he's covered the middle so many times where it looks like for sure he's trapped. Again, this ball could have hit him in the left shoulder had he not moved quickly enough. He was on his left foot for that shot, Don.
Here he comes.
He's able to bring that elbow into the body and get the racket so close to the right shoulder to cover. Really amazing.
Backhand down the line from Liang. The tactics were good. He just overhit it. But again, if I was coaching a player did that, I'd be quite happy. He's got to be brave here. He's got to go for difficult shots against Ma Long.
That is absolutely stunning. Turns the corner. I was sure it was going cross court. Liang Jingkun sets up, watches movement. Same with him.
He's gone.
He's right gone. Down the line.
He's gambled and he's lost his money. But just look, it was on the white line. Perfect placement.
Over the table, though, the control. Now, in terms of versatility, I mean, Ma Long has been described as the most complete player in the game. He's got more weaponry. Power, that's up for debate. Liang Jingkun is very strong, possibly even more power. Ma Long loves the forehand and is going to try to use the forehand as much as possible, but still has a steady backhand to surprise. What touch right off the bounce. Good retrieve there against the flip kill. Liang Jingkun gets one tough ball back, anticipates and moves quickly. Or more so, I'd say moves quickly, gets in position. But Ma Long takes all the pace off. That was the truest block we've seen, really slowing the ball down.
The soft block.
Exactly.
A positive block, even just because you don't hit the ball hard doesn't mean to say it's not positive. Six all. Well, he's back. 6 points apiece, 5-1 down, 6-all.
So 83% of the last 6 points, give or take, have gone to Ma Long. This is control. This is the ability to recognize what the opponent is doing and turn it against them.
Didn't really get in position there, I didn't feel. Liang sort of seemed quite stiff when he played the backhand. Let's just have another look at this. The return into his body.
Ma Long makes it really uncomfortable, sort of coming in at the side of the ball for the push with a little bit of side spin.
Eight. Six, seven.
But I think that's one of the many abilities that Ma Long has to make the opponent uncomfortable at any speed. Eight. Now, not. Six. It wasn't an especially. I mean, they were both sort of waiting for the other one to make the attack, and no one really made the move.
That was just soft backhand, soft backhand. It was like you and I doing backhands to backhands.
From what I hear, it's like me and one of your students. I can't even say that because I guess you've coached all the best players in England, so. But me, anyway, look more like me than you.
Eight, seven.
First point in a long time. Liang Jingkun, again, as you mentioned, was up 5-1. Second serve here for Ma Long. Tends to work well to his advantage.
Second serve coming up, big point.
Forehand comes in, point over. With that backhand, it was again, they were both sort of waiting to see who would spend the most time and energy on a shot to counter. You have to imagine that Liang Jingkun studied, and I think everybody has studied, the 2017 men's singles final. And Ma Long's tactics of patiently waiting mid-table to let the first attack come in before making his counter. His parallel here is just so quick and tough to predict.
The two angles there. First one was wide into the backhand, then the rocket down the line. Here we'll see that again. Diagonal down the line. And Liang not able to predict when that shot's coming down the line. He's just not quite reading.
This one sounded like it hit the hand of Ma Long holding the racket, which is still fine. It's just tougher to control in general. So one game point saved. Now again, to credit Ma Long in terms of being readable, I think the bend of his wrist, the movement of his body, he's found so many different levels that he can deceive his opponent on. That makes him very threatening and incredibly difficult to prepare for. And a wide serve tempting him from that deep angle to go to the backhand. Ma Long takes game one from down 1-5, completely doctors up the situation, dictates the score as a dictator does, and is leading 1-0. We'll be back for game number two right after this. Thank you. Ma Long fan club in the house, showing themselves. They're all over the building. It's tough to miss them. They'd be happy to give you a flag, a banner, or something to support the captain himself if you run into him. So here Ma Long goes, leading 1-0, starting game two with the serve. Little break off the net there for Liang Jingqun, little fortune.
It's amazing, isn't it? Just that slight tweak in the trajectory of the ball. And it's going that quick. Impossible to return.
Two, love.
Started a little slow in the first game, Ma Long, 5-1 down.
Yeah, that was pretty surprising, but it just speaks again to how strong he is. That he's able to be 1-5 down and turn things around just like that. And out in front, a very wristy backhand there. That was almost the placement he gave Liang Jingqun at 10-8 in the last game. That wide serve to the backhand, just slightly wider for that serve. Good timing here, takes it really early to go parallel. Ma Long just a little bit on the backhand side, maybe looking for an opportunity to get the forehand in. Doesn't miss by a lot. It's actually tough to tell how he missed. You know, it looked like he was actually there. Oh, he got stuck. The pancake flip was pretty decent. But after that, I think he got satisfied for a moment. Just put too much in terms of body movement for this shot. And for the second time we've seen it where he's turned the corner, not chased down the next ball. This one seemed a little bit closer to reachable than the one before.
Yeah, I think Ma didn't quite get round sufficiently, even for him, because he can lean, contort himself. But even by still fairly soft by his high standards.
Net post and out, point to Liang Jingqun.
5-1.
So 5-1 again. Deja vu.
Yeah, we will see. From that angle, it looked like could have been side. Getting a lot of different camera angles for perspective, but no question it was Liang Jingqun's point. It would be interesting. Will be more interesting in theory if Liang Jingqun capitalized on one of these big leads early on. The angle takes one from the middle, covers the middle, and then wide out of reach. Again, almost every shot to that wide forehand, Ma Long puts some side spin on.
I mean, he plays that from the middle of the table. When the ball's wide to your forehand, it's easier to get an angle. But to get that angle from the middle is quite amazing.
Indeed. This looked a little bit more like a chop block on Liang Jingqun's side. Yeah, that is a really good point. He's done that time and time again. He's covered the middle so well, almost like he's got a full stroke, but it's not. It's usually a weak point for a lot of players. And it still might be for Ma Long, but he's just that strong.
Liang there, fist punches the air.
Well, he definitely wants to change history here in the sense of not reliving game number one, rewrite it in game number two, continue to run away with the lead, hold on to that advantage. Soft and spinny. Licked a little bit shallower on the table, but very thin contact from Ma Long on the backhand side.
I was surprised there because the return was quite high. I thought he'd come in and hit it, but to do a slow topspin against the high push. There's the high push.
Right.
And then the slow topspin. So, yep, very clever.
I remember feeling the same thing. The surprise factor is always high with Ma Long. It's the same page in many respects. When he turns the corner and takes the forehand, Liang Jingqun has started winning a big percentage of these points going wide out.
He's reading the direction of the Ma Long topspin. First game, when Ma Long came back from 5-1, he aced him quite a few times. He seems to be waiting for it this time.
Service warning, looking down for what it was.
7-4.
Asking him to make sure he throws it up the at least 6 inches in an upwards direction.
So was it the height or
the height? The height.
Okay, yeah. Okay.
5-7.
Yeah, it felt like the tactic of letting Ma Long step around and play the forehand. The word let sounds, yeah, a little bit too free. I mean, just setting Ma Long up to take the bait and play a parallel shot on the step around, allowing him to have that first big attack, then creating the counter is a bit of a taste of the Ma Long medicine. Wow, lunging to get around that one. Even the Ma Long fan club says, man, that's pretty good. Shaking their heads like, geez, what can you do against that? Throws everything in on this one. Ma Long's point of view for that, blasted right down the middle. Net recovery and a blast. It looked like it almost took his head off. He was squatting there. Had to duck under, keep the racket up.
I've watched this forehand, how powerful this forehand is. Just look at that. Nearly knocked his head off.
And this was all off of a net ball from Liang Jingquin. Or at least a little earlier in the rally. 2 points between them now. This one sits up a little bit. Good calibration here to move in, keep the racket closed. We'll have a much better perspective here from down low. Oh yeah, that one really comes up. But you could see how low it flattened out because of the heavy topspin on it, just jumping away from the net. Now I wouldn't expect, the first time I saw Liang Jingquin, I wouldn't expect him to be so fast on his feet, but he really moves well.
Fast topspin from Ma Long, caught the top of the net, flicked it off the end of the table. 4 game points for Liang Jingquin.
Ooh, deep on the table, the ball sneaks past Ma Long and Liang Jingquin takes game number 2, 11-6, more dominant than the dictator was in game number 1, so outscoring Ma Long so far this match. 17-19 right now, and it's 1 game apiece. We'll be back for game number 3 to see who takes the lead right after this. Back for game number 3, Liang Jingquin with the serve. Hits it into the hand here.
Liang there, not sure whether to play backhand or forehand, ended up hesitating, playing a half backhand.
It's exactly what the dictator wanted with that middle. Handled the heat on the first one. Ma Long had a very aggressive shot that Liang Jingquin guided right back, trying to pin the middle. This one. And it comes back quickly right into the elbow. This is the perfect view for this point. Wow. Sounded like a very European Chinese. Oh. Not the first time we've seen that routine. The step around and the full out forehand. It's the one hit wonder, but it ends the point. It works. Malong taking the risk with the long serve to the deep corner. Still doesn't get around Liang Jingkun's forehand. Two in a row.
That was very deep. Perfect length. Bounced on the white line. I just wonder if we'll see Malong do a long fast serve down the line.
I've been waiting for that for a long time. I mean, throughout his career, there have been just a very large collection of highlight reels on YouTube and around the world watching him mesmerizing audiences, and that serve we don't get to see so often. Nice placement here. He changed it up. So many times before, he'd go for power to the forehand, but he waits to see the movement and then fans the ball, just brushes it to the backhand side, and it pays off. Really nice change of patterns, I'd say. Slowing down the game a little bit for placement.
Clever play by Leong, just spun up the back of the ball. By the time he was in position to play, the ball had dropped. Difficult to get a lot of pace on the ball. See again on the replay. Steps around, the ball's beneath the table, so he brushes up the back of the ball, spins it deep. Clever tactics.
Ball in the backcourt. Notice that as well. When you're the serving player, you don't want to have to be seeing more than one ball mid-rally. Not at this level, not at this stage. Parallel, looked like he was going to go cross court. He's constantly keeping Liang Jingkun guessing, except for the rare occasion when he's played the line a little bit closer on the step around. But I feel like his peripheral vision right now is playing a huge role in where he decides to go. He's able to accelerate so smoothly and simply to just take the ball early and really put the pressure on. Just a little bit slower from Liang Jingkun, and Malong leaps forward and explodes through.
Good angle as well, wide into Liang's backhand.
Started to turn a little bit quickly. Liang Jingkun plays the risky shot down the forehand line. I'm really impressed with his decision-making, Liang Jingkun. Like, he's recognizing the patterns, predicting what Malong might do next. So just 1 point down with the second serve here.
Got away with the weak return there, Malong. Weak by his standards, I hasten to add. It was just a little bit high, but he got himself back into the point. And now the point open. And there you can see by his expression, Liang top spins the ball into the net.
Had a good look at his under chin goatee there. It's a special, only he does it. Absolute table tennis brilliance in that point. I'm thinking to myself, he's picking different points on the table every shot in this rally, and as soon as it's blasted to the middle, he plays it perfectly. Again, it's like living vicariously through your hero. It's like a video game for him. He can do anything. Note to self, work harder at life. So what a turnaround here. 3 points in a row for Malong. He was up 5-4, coming into the second towel break. The point before this at 4-6 was just devastating. Because really, Liang Jingkun didn't do anything wrong. He played really well. That would have won the point against pretty much any other player here.
He ran around the backhand, played a wonderful forehand topspin, and lo and behold, it was blasted past him.
It's so fearless. A beautiful shot from Liang Jingkun down low. Malong slows it down a little bit with a spinny shot and then goes for broke on the next shot, and he'll make that a good percentage of the time. Liang Jingkun gets the best of him here. Slow spinny from way down low. Here's a perfect look. Well, that's the angle that would make it quite clear why it was so puzzling for Ma Long. Love about this. Superheroes and the side spin comes into play. Ma Long pulled a Simone Gauzy out here with the side under for the last shot. Way, way above speed limit. That ball right there actually looked a little bit more like side top on the replay, but it's heavy, heavy side. Beautiful cover of the middle there. That's an incredibly difficult and awkward shot, but Lihong Jin-Quin earns himself the opportunity and wins the point. Footwork moving back into the table, non-stop here, he can't rest.
That's the shot where he put side spin on it, and that's the one that won him the point.
Jeez, the in and out factor just everywhere, his feet have to move for that.
8-4, 8-7.
They've both gone on their streaks, it's three in a row for each side now. I'm thinking back watching these two play about the point of the century that you were commentating on in 2015 with Fang Bo and with Ma Long. It was a 4-2 victory for Ma Long in the end. I think some people forget how close it was. Timeout here on Ma Long's side. Game number three. We're only in the third game, each player only having one so far, but it feels so deep already. The importance of every point and, of course, every game in this. I mean, an early timeout for no coaches in the corner, Don.
I think it's a real pivotal moment now. Whoever goes 2-1 up, I know it's an obvious thing to say, whoever goes 2-1 up is in with a much stronger chance. Momentum was with Ma Long, 5-4, 3 points on the run, 8-4 up, and we saw a couple of fantastic points. And there he is, the dictator. He was amazing. But then all of a sudden, Leong answers, two or three great points, momentum back with him. So the master tactician Ma Long decides, let's have a timeout, let's break this momentum and let's try and win this third game. Crucial game.
You know, that one point where Leong Jin-Quin played the ball with the racket straight up to cover the middle, Ma Long played a passive next shot. I was a little surprised that he played that heavy side spin, almost bowling step shot, because he had time. But, you know, the shot doesn't work out for him. How many times have we been surprised that he did something and it did work out for him? Probably more than the other way around by quite a lot. So, just fascinating.
But I think there was so much spin on that shot from Liang.
Interesting. It was definitely an awkward ball. So here we go, 1 point up, still out of the timeout. Dictator with the serve. Oh, forehand for forehand. When you hear Da Pang grunting, Lihong Jin-Quin, Ma Long still just counters it back even better. The angles and the risks he's willing to take. Oh, I just can't believe a human being can play at his speed so comfortably. I don't like to use the word perfection very often, but I feel very lucky to watch Ma Long play. This is good placement here on the push. Ma Long caught between a rock and a hard place on this one.
Leong there just put a little bit of side spin on the ball, I think, on that push as well, to make it a little bit more awkward for Ma Long.
I sense some hesitation because he knew he was leaving open most of the table there and wasn't sure if he could finish the point with that one shot. That's how it felt. Tight serve shuts down the forehand flick. 9 points apiece from 8-4. It's been streaky back and forth, but that's, what, 5 out of the last 6 points for Leong Jin-Quin?
Ma Long now with the advantage of his two serves to come.
We've seen some long serves to the deep backhand court, and this is sort of that poker face drill. He looks him right in the eyes, tries to sense what he's thinking, sense his temperature, if he's feeling bold or nervous. Similar to the serve in game one, a little more inside the table. Why did the backhand? What are you thinking, Don?
Well, Leon there will be disappointed. There's a good chance to step round that one. He ends up playing it a little bit cramped. Again, I just think he's a bit worried. Is Marlon going to go down the line?
And also with the placement there, though, Marlon kept it so that it was half long perfectly, might have not even come off the table. Game point, Marlon. Oh, just enough. A little bit of extra spin. When you start to hear that grunt from Marlon on the step around, business. And the contract is signed here in game number three. The dictator dictates. He takes game three. 2-1 lead. Ma Long versus Liang Jingquan. Game four coming up right after this. Back for game number four, a crucial game number three there. Ma Long has spent his time out, and it's paid off so far. He's in the lead. And the calm before the storm, controlled start to the point.
It's a very gentle backhand to backhand rally. Ma Long winning the point.
The angle. He's so in control of that wide shot. Long serve, gets it back long. I can't believe the speed of that ball, Don.
Backhand to backhand, soft the first rally, and then it's a rocket comes out the second. The service was a rocket.
Polar opposites. And that's one of his clever tactics. I mean, keeping you guessing. If you start to get comfortable against Ma Long, he's doing something wrong. Or you're doing something really right, I should say, but by his standards, anyway. The opening backhand was too strong, popped the ball up just a little bit in the forehand, just out of reach.
An amazing amount of wrist action in that service return, that backhand service return.
So serves back with the dictator now. So iconic, his serves. He's a player for Turkey who plays exactly like Ma Long, just slightly lower level.
Good return of service there by Leong.
Yeah, I thought it was clever to try to bring Ma Long in over the table, but he had to keep it so low to deter the flip so that he had a chance to play it deep back to the backhand corner. Classic combination, short to the forehand, deep to the backhand.
That's when he's at his best, I think. It's so difficult when he plays that forehand from the backhand side and he's in position. Just watch him here, rounding up. Where's that going?
Well, he's gone so many times to the forehand and he's paid for it. Here he plays a little bit more safe in terms of using the length of the table on the diagonal. And even if it comes back, he's more likely to be in position to reach it by going cross court first. Caught flat-footed for a moment, took the shot a little earlier. You know, usually we see Ma Long in position or very comfortable to play the ball midair, but this, it almost looked like his feet forgot, sort of leaned and reached.
Maybe he thought he could lean and reach it. Then he realized he's leaning and he's not going to get there, and he stumbled after the ball.
I think that is a very fair assessment of what just happened. Wow, the bend on that backhand, the crowd oohing and aahing. A shot that makes swarms of fan clubs blush in an instant. See it one more time. Heavy spin, yoink. Liang Jingquin has to go for almost an around the net shot here, a hooking forehand back.
It's amazing. So there's so much backspin on that ball and side spin when it hit the table, the kick out. Just lets you know how much side spin there is on the ball.
I saw one shot from Ma Long where he used the backhand from the middle and came down like a chop block. No, it was a forehand that looked like a backhand chop block. I think it was the earlier rounds in the team event.
Just as you say there, Adam, he's now running round and going on the diagonal. And I think the very reason you said he's been caught out a couple of times when he's gone down the line, exposed himself out wide on his forehand. Now there's no way that Leon can get an angle out wide to his forehand. At best, he can go down the line.
Right, this is a much safer plan.
4-6.
This one gets away just a little bit. I think Ma Long, typically very strong in these quick counters. Sounded like it caught the edge of the racket a little bit. This is two points in a row that have been a bit surprising for me. Not because they were easy, but because Ma Long has been making these pretty consistently and missed the contact altogether on this one. Huh.
Whether it's the bounce of the ball, I'm not sure. That was most uncharacteristic of Ma Long. Long fast push. Deep, aggressive. Great variation.
I just want to point out, if you're newer to table tennis and tuning in, that's how highly we think of Ma Long. If he misses a shot, often there must have been something wrong. I mean, it's just so uncommon, especially if someone doesn't hit a clear winner. So 7 points up to 5 right now. Still ahead, 2 games to 1. Nice surprise placement. Caught Ma Long off guard there. Strong receive. Now over the table, Liang Jingquin is very strong. He moves well. He fully commits for this shot. The backhand opening right at the baseline. And you can already see he's in position for the next shot. Ma Long didn't get the setup he wanted. Comes across the ball. A little bit of side, a whole lot of top. And Ma Long quickly takes that shot. Now, I feel like this is a tactical decision. When he comes across the body just a little bit on that, it makes it faster, and it's a little bit more surprising to the opponent because it's not technically the textbook shot. Seen Timo do this time and time again. It's worked quite effectively.
7-8.
A third point for me. Again, a bit more spin, a little bit less speed from Liang Jingquin to break it up. Guy's trying to eat his goatee. Did you see that? Guy in the crowd?
Missed it.
Okay. Maybe in the replay. A little bit off the net. That was the acknowledgement there at the end. We don't see Ma Long fishing too often, waiting for his opportunity to strike back. He could feel that he didn't want to be there for long, which is part of the reason he did it against a ball that hit the net. You just heard players, which I assume is players, you know what to do. Don't take too long. Have you ever seen a double yellow card?
I'm trying to think what a double yellow card would mean. Second warning. He slipped there. I hope he's okay.
Me too.
He went for a... Put his foot down on the floor, put his weight on his foot. Let's just see here.
Whoa.
That's Leon. Seems okay.
Huh. stretching out the ankle a little bit. You know, these fast movements, he seems okay, and I hope he is, but something subtle like that can really take a toll, either hyperextending.
The crowd relieved to see him fit, I think. That's a fabulous response, isn't it, from the crowd?
Well, you know, he's got so much love and adoration from around the world that in his 6 months gone, I mean, I've never received more messages about his well-being in my life. And 9 points apiece. Man. Still thinking about that slip. You know, Ma Long once said his greatest enemy, injury. Which is actually quite an interesting statement and insightful, really. He's confident that as long as he's fit, he knows what to do, he can do the job. But injury, just has to avoid that. So Liang Jingquan now with the serves on his side at 9 points each, the reverse of last game. Ma Long controlling, keeping him away from the table. Ma Long staying right on top of the bounce. That threat of Ma Long to take the quick forehand and go wide to the forehand side. He's comfortable to stay close, says I don't have to do too much with the backhand, but he keeps Liang Jingquan about a step behind the table with his deep sort of counter blocks. So game point for Ma Long. He's taken control. It's creepy how calm he is throughout this point. Just chilling that he can wait there. And he is chilling, but it is chilling watching him handle the power and the spin of Liang Jingquan time after time. Just allowing the opponent to punch, to attack and swing. And as soon as he goes for it, he makes the right decision in the timing and he takes it. He takes the game, the dictator, up 3-1. Holding his body together, in control. We'll see what happens. Game number 5 coming up right after this. Back for game number 5 at the start of game 4. They were even in points despite Ma Long leading 2-1. But another narrow margin victory and Ma Long up 3-1 against Liang Jingquan.
Great forehand topspin from Liang there straight down the line.
Now watch when Ma Long takes his forehand. Oh, it's the backhand rather. But the way he got his body into it, it took him a little bit of time. His foot was still coming down, that left foot. So the other corner was the perfect choice for Liang Jingquan. Good depth on the table. It makes Ma Long look not slow, because he never looks slow unless he intends that. Just slightly slower than that lightning flash forehand that he's made so many times.
A little bit more backspin on the ball than Liang thought. Hold the racket very loose, as you can see there, for the service. Just allows a little bit more wrist action to go into it.
Gotta love that control again near the back of the table. Setting himself up, refuses to leave his post. right at the baseline, using his serve very effectively. Both players so far have won both of their services for points. This one was so close. That's the type of shot that we see Ma Long chop block when it comes down, but he was waiting patiently at the back of the table.
That return was perfect length. The second bounce, was it coming long? Was it going to bounce twice? Slight hesitation. Leung eventually let it drop and had to spin up the back.
Where does this one come from? What's he going to do? It's like he's just sort of following the ball along the table and then decides, now is time to accelerate. I would like to do that now. The ball is gone.
That looked as though it could have been over the table, but
that's the craziest thing about it. Saw Ma Long do that in doubles as well. Men's doubles world champion with Wang Chuqin.
Backhand to backhand on the diagonal. What a rally.
He just has that comfort. It sounds like we've got a timeout here on Liang Jingquin's side, down 3 points. I was going to say, at no point in that rally for me did it feel like Ma Long was ever making his move. He was just sort of saying, let's see if you can make yours. I'm going to keep spinning it low, deep to the back of the table. I'm not going to spend much effort. Short stroke.
But I think the thing is, when it's Ma Long and he's doing that, you're thinking, when is he going to run round? When is he going to put one down the line? So you're under pressure because you're expecting him to do it, and you can't believe that he's played 4 shots to the same spot with the same spin and the same speed.
It's like a time bomb. You know at some point that man right there on the bottom of his own racket, Ma Long, one of the most popular rackets in the world currently because of his performances, you know? It's just at any given moment he could explode and suddenly it's panic mode.
I think the timeout by Leung was appropriate. 3-1 down, 5-2. Just sense that he's slipping away. He'll be hoping now that the momentum has been broken and he'll need to win a couple of the first few points, get himself back into this fifth game.
Without any prediction of the future and trying not to use hindsight so much, I think that is the perfect timeout, because in these very tight games he could have taken the game and saved his timeout, but here, this is a really important point. Still, the game's starting to get away, but not out of reach. The 3-point differential. Who would have known before that Ma Long would end up taking the games, the last two, 11-9? I actually think from the timeout standpoint, if there were a coach in the corner, that's exactly when they would have called it. I'm trying to pay attention now, once the rally gets started, to what Liang Jingquin is doing to make it difficult for Ma Long. I think positioning and placement is going to be a big part of it. Tested, smart play. He sees that Liang Jingquin's moving to the backhand and says, you know what, I'm going to race you there. I'm going to hit it as wide as you can because I know you want the forehand here, but I don't want to let you have it. Confiscated, that's the word I was thinking of. It's not the first time that Ma Long has confiscated the forehand of Liang Jingquin. He'll give it back after class. Oh, beautiful.
The service was excellent from Leung, and then he followed him with that backhand topspin down the line. There's the spinny, wristy action. Ball pops up. Whoosh, backhand topspin down the line. He knows where his mistake was. It was on the return.
Just in case your eyes haven't wandered over to that part of the screen, Ma Long still leading by 2 with the serves on his side. Interesting. He really picks so many different places on the table. Dance cam in the middle of the match. Always having a good time here.
Heavy backspin on the serve, cutting underneath the ball. The ball fizzing with backspin.
Let's. 7-4.
Ooh, just a hair uncomfortably out wide to the forehand. It's probably the second or third time in this entire match that I've seen Ma Long go for that wide forehand, which most would have trouble with, but just not quite get there early enough or wide enough to counter it back. Don, I feel nervous.
I think Leong needs these 2 points with his service.
Matthias Falk fans getting set up for the next match, enjoying this one here.
Moved it around in the backhand very cleverly. One was near the center line, and then the next one was wide to the backhand. So even though it's backhand to backhand, watch here. And then that one wide to the backhand.
Right, he's so subtle. It's just like his serve. It's not the iconic serves of Dima. It's a traditional pendulum serve, but he's added his own flavor to it, and it's so difficult to read. So good movement here by Leong Jingquin to get in over the table and create that wide angle. If he waits for it to come a little bit deeper, suddenly it's a more narrow, more predictable set of options there. A more acute angle.
1 point apiece on that sequence of two. I think Ma Long would have settled for that. He's now got his own serve to come.
Right, the burden is definitely on the side of Leong Jingquin to change the patterns here. One for one will win Ma Long the match if it continues that way. Oh, once again burned, hung out to dry. It's been a while since we've seen that happen at the beginning of the match. Oh, the nerves are building in the Ma Long fan club.
That was a great flick by the pancake, as you've christened it, and I like it because he comes in with an open angle and suddenly
it's
flicks
tricky.
The pancake, whips that wrist action, gets through the ball, turns what you think is going to be a push into a flick.
Leong Jingquin's seen the breakfast made before by the dictator, so he was quick to react. Still 1 point up, big one here. Ooh, well handled. He's played this serve under pressure a few times, wider to the backhand, a little shallow on the table, but Leong Jingquin taking a big risk here says, I'm not gonna get passive, I'm not gonna play it soft and spinny, I'm gonna drive it for a win, and steals the point. So this is his real chance to crack it open. Leong Jingquin with the serves on his side, tied up. That is incredible. Ma Long has played these wide shots a few times with the forehand. Leong Jingquin covers it. I don't even know how. We have to see it again. I mean, he completely lost his footing on this. He slapped it back. Just
so
one good shot. Yeah.
So aggressive on the forehand.
There it is, the cross court, the safer ones. The last several times that he's gone deep to the backhand corner with the forehand, it's been more effective than the risk he's taken playing down the line or to the wide forehand, even in the rally from the middle and forehand side. I think Leong Jingquin's backhand is very strong when he has time and when it's over the table. But against Ma Long's opening forehand, it's just too much pressure coming in. That's probably his safest bet. So once again, third game in a row, we're seeing 9 each. Ma Long has taken the last two. He's got the serves on his side now, as he would in all the odd games at 9-9, 1-3-5, and 7 if needed. Ooh! I thought Ma Long, it was one of those chilling moments, the way he was able to slow it down, change the pace, bring Leong Jingquin in and out a little bit. But the last ball from Leong Jingquin, heavy spin, and it's blocked up and out. Only takes that much of the racket being just a little bit open for it to go long. Liang Jingquan with a game point to keep the match alive and take this to game six. Build up some pressure. Forehand turning from the middle, plays it right into the body, gets a passive shot out of Liang Jingquan. Watch the serve, shorter side of half long to the forehand. That's what you need to be doing.
Yeah, if he goes into the forehand, he's giving Liang a chance, and he's playing the counter forehand topspin so well, is Liang. Opening up into the backhand, the body, proving that a little bit more effective for Ma Long.
So Dapang now, Liang Jingquan with the serve. Alternating serves at deuce here in game number five. Ma Long earns himself match points. We will see. The winner here has one more match, the championship match. But this match could be the biggest hurdle considering the way the crazy, crazy draw has ended up. Serve on his side for his first and the only match point we've seen so far.
It's got to be a short serve. Surely he's not going to go with a long, fast one.
Well, I'm thinking he's going to go with a long, fast one after that. Ooh, back edge of the table for Liang Jingquan.
Touch.
Yeah. Oh, ever so slightly. I think the body language of Ma Long, in addition to the sound, were the two best indicators there. I laughed for a few reasons. One, that he caught the edge in that crucial moment, hanging on by a thread. And two, I mean, it was 50-50 in some senses, or maybe less for me calling the long serve, but he did serve short, as you said. So second deuce point. Wow, fortune at just the right time. Ooh, heavy topspin from in over the backhand, or in over the forehand side with the backhand. Look, one more time, the receive for a third ball. I mean, that is a lot of work for a third ball. That's more like a receive shot. Ma Long's going to have to deceive if it comes down to that receive game again. Get Liang Jingquan backpedaling a little bit. What's it going to be? Game point, Liang Jingquan. As wide as can be to the backhand. It's such a very small area on the table that you can serve to that gets a predictable shot back that Ma Long is able to counter like this. Just a little bit inside the table, the bounce of Liang Jingquan's opening spin shot. So with the fourth towel break, it's tied up third deuce point. What are you thinking, Don?
I'm just thinking he plays that forehand topspin so well there, straight into the body of Liang. I'm also thinking that if this does turn around, that millimeter, that edge ball, that's the difference between winning and losing, potentially. Let's see. Oh, the serve drifted long.
Ma Long is so good at reading when the ball is available to attack. That opening spin shot wasn't a kill shot, but it was as loaded and fizzing with spin, as we might say, as could possibly be. Second match point for Ma Long.
With the serve, again, got to be short, and then look to get in, but I'm very conservative.
Long serve deep to the backhand. No, he does it! Ma Long in the tight game follows Don's prediction. 14-12, the dictator has gotten through the Chinese opposition. First Lin Gaoyuan in the dark night. Now Liang Jingquan, Dapang, and he only has one match left to be a three-time back-to-back-to-back world champion, and it will not be a Chinese opponent. It will either be An Jae-hyun or it'll be Matthias Falk, Korea or Sweden. Those are the opponents, the options left for the dictator. What a test here many people were quite curious to see what would happen, and I'm part of that group. Liang Jingquin played some incredible table tennis at 22 years old, challenged the most complete player in the game, but he roars back Shawshank style out here. Looking up at the sky, Ma Long has gotten through and only has one more test to what could put his name in stone until anyone else passes him by as the greatest player of all time. But still one match left, and we will see respect to Liang Jingquin. We'll see a lot more of him, the player that beat Fang Zhendong and got through Koki Niwa in quite an exciting match, but knocked out the world number one. Couldn't do the same to Ma Long. 4-1, but man, were they tight, Don.
And I think that's one of his incredible strengths. Technically, he's amazing. Skill-wise, amazing, but mentally so tough.
So
and he's now going to say a few words.
This tough match, because each set was so close, but at the end, you made it. So what was the most important thing for this match?
恭喜你取得了4-1的胜利，因为每一场的比分都非常的接近，但最后关键时刻你还是拿下了比赛。你觉得获胜的关键是什么呢？我觉得今天从一开始吧，自己打的还是比较主动，并没有说去等靠梁靖昆失误，然后在1-1的情况下，其实后三局自己都是阶段性比分领先，但是中间也出现一些问题，但庆幸是在关键球的时候自己处理的还是比较坚决吧，然后觉得今天打的确实也不错吧。
So from the very beginning, I was leading, but then Liang Jingquin came back. So there were some moments and there were some important balls that I was very determined and stuck to the match because I was very active in the match, not instead of waiting for Liang Jingquin to make mistakes. So for me, I think I played pretty well in this match. So now you are into the final. What would you see for the final? 现在你进入了决赛，你对于决赛怎么看呢？
觉得无论对手是谁吧，这也是一次机会，也是一个压力，所以希望自己想挑战一下。So
no matter who will be my opponent, this is an opportunity, but this is also a challenge. So I would like to take the challenge. Thank you. 谢谢。
Well, there you have it. Ma Long speaks. He has spoken here in the semifinals. Signature on screen. A challenge lies ahead. But the honor of fighting for the gold medal has been earned once again by Ma Long and will be fought for by Matthias Falk and An Jae-hyun. Stick around, that match coming up just after this.